no smoke. Pass me the joint so I can take a toke. One puff, two puff, three puff, four puff, five. I'm feeling real high. Leaning to the side in my motherfucking ride with the OG gangsta glide. Woo! Hey, now you know. Inhale, exhale with my flow. Breakaway, come again.
The forest fire segment. What's going on in cannabis news with Million Dollar Man? What can you tell the listeners about what's happening with cannabis?
I mean, as far as you know, what strains? What some of the strains that I'm on? What's popping out here? The new products? Well, actually, yeah, there's finally. I noticed that there are a few other states that are allowing cannabis drinks now. Beverages are on the market now.
So have you tried any of these cannabis beverages yet? Tell us what you think about what you tried, if you have.
Man, I had a root beer. My daughter brought me this root beer. 100% THC can of pop. It's a soda. It's by a company called King. And this was earlier in 2023. When this happened, and a few other states like California and Washington hadn't already adopted or let beverages come out yet. I think Oregon was one of the first states. But it was great, man. It came in a resealable can. You know, like a can of pop comes and you could crack the, well, this particular company has a resealable can to actually keep your beverage fresh. And you can't drink the whole thing all at once. I mean, you're gonna have to put it down, set it down, all that. I even also tried a different company's amber beer. I didn't like it too well, so I didn't want to bash the company, but I filmed it. Well, I didn't bash the company. It's just that the particular ginger beer didn't agree with my palate. I mean, it actually did the job, but going down, it was like drinking castor oil.
Oh yeah, yeah. I feel you on that. Sometimes that happens from time to time.
When you're trying things, that's why people go to wine tasting. Sometimes they bring that little spit cup. If it don't agree with your palate, you gotta spit that shit out. You know what I'm saying? And try again. You know what I'm saying? But the best thing is when you drink it something like that. If you got something you can smoke on the side. And you got to agree with your palate. You can kind of fix that and, you know, auto correct it with some good cannabis weed. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man, most definitely. Most definitely. So that's what I did.
I knew you would. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I got to give a shout out to all our listeners on 98.5 KMIX Los Angeles. This is our very first forest fire segment in years. I mean, we last did a forest fire segment maybe, five, six years ago when Valesse had joined. And everybody on 98.5 who's listening on the LPFM radio station, they're big fans of our forest fire segment, especially when we have this cannabis culture icon, KB, the million-dollar mouthpiece, on the line with us because he's very big in the cannabis culture. He's got a Sex and Strains, Strain U channel. And I know you're over there taking a big old puff of that Dingleberry K over there, but you know what I'm saying? I can't say it as well as the million-dollar mouthpiece can. My mouthpiece ain't worth no million. This is it right here.
This is the little mouthpiece I got right here. But let's hear from the million-dollar. Matter of fact, did they upgrade your mouthpiece over there? It's worth more than a million now, right? What's going on? I see you coughing and shit. Let me get a little sip of the drinky drink and shit, but I heard they upgraded your mouthpiece and shit. Is it worth more than $1 million or what?
What you smoking on, man?
Actually, I'm smoking on a couple strains right now. On my new strain review that I got out, I'm blowing on some of that Wedding Burger, which is really exclusive. And I'm blowing on some of this Jealousy. It's called Jealousy. Oh, man, that shit is bomb. Straight indicas, indica hybrids. They actually are appetite inducers. Kind of couchy. I would smoke this. They actually taste really nice, real good. It's that exclusive danky dank, old school dank. Make you cough and sweat. You could actually have a real nice time on this. It's a muscle relaxer also.
So tell people who don't know, what's new in cannabis news? What's happening in the world that's different in 2024? I know a lot of new laws have changed and shit like that. Federally, they changed the categories of things and shit, but how does that help out growers, people who sell seeds, people who smoke weed? They might want to send weed from one state to another. Let's say I'm in California and I got some really good weed and I want to give it to you in Oregon. How does that all work for our listeners that's on layman's terms and shit?
I'm going to say this. If you are in a legal state and you want to do that, you want to consult your local medical or your state's local medical marijuana advisory board or their board. That's what I'm going to say to you.
All right. There it is right there. The $1 million mouthpiece just told y'all, consult your local medical marijuana advisory board.
Yeah. In your state.
So yeah. What's happening with game news? I see your game news shirt and shit, man. What's happening with the game news, man? It's not in me. It's on me. What's going on with the game news, man? Tell us about that.
News that you can use, man. Everything that's going to come out of my mouth, everything that I support. As a matter of fact, y'all go check the single out. You know, you type in game news. Anywhere, Instagram, anywhere, man, on all platforms. I got an animated video for it. It's a song. It's actually featuring my nephew, Six. Happy birthday, Sporty. You know, that's why I'm wearing the purple. Shout out, Sporty.
I got purple on, too, for you, Sporty. I probably
wouldn't be here.
You know what I'm saying? Sporty.
I probably wouldn't even be here as far as music-wise. That's a different story, but shout out to my nephew, Six. Shout out to Mr. Movable Beats for actually putting the beat together. But yeah, man, that single's out there. Go run the numbers up on YouTube. It's called Gang News. I'm just serving the real, man, featuring my nephew Six. It's just up on some real West Coast hip hop good game, man. It's a dope rap song, man. And thinking about doing some more stuff, you know? Just motivated, man. You know, the animated video is out. You know, my nephew, Mo Dub Creations, we just dropped a new video. We got Bust This out there. We got Pain by WDN. Keep Rolling just dropped. All 3D animated. And it's not an app. We actually do own the software. Shout out to my nephew, Mo Dub Creations. And you will see an animated stream review coming from us real soon. That's going to be coming up real quick. An animated stream review. I probably shouldn't even say nothing, but yeah, the first animated stream review, man, coming from us, you know, should be coming out here soon, man. I don't know, probably about 2-3 weeks, take some time, but yeah, man, it's going to be coming out. And I shoot that, I put that out there on YouTube. You actually can go check that out on my Twitter page. That's in real time, in real life. But this strain review is going to be by me. I'm advertising Cook Lucky Dog, a nice indica strain out here. And what you see out there, as the review on like my social media page, you'll see that same review animated. So it's something that, you know, me and my nephew was talking about, and we're going to turn it into fruition. So be on the lookout for that.
So what's your favorite strain you ever had before all this cannabis stuff was like legal? You know what I'm saying? And it was all like regulated and everything. Like, what's your favorite weed you ever smoked? Take you back like 20, 30, 40, whatever years, man. Like, what's your favorite strain?
Really?
Street
so far?
Strain. Yeah.
Or like back in the day.
Back in the day.
For real? It's a couple of them, man. That OG Kush, okay? And that Granddaddy Purple.
Granddaddy Purple. Hey, you know what's crazy? You said Granddaddy Purple? I got to tell you this. I'm wearing this hat. This hat used to belong to my wife's grandfather, and he recently passed away. And it is purple. It's crazy you brought up Sporty. We're both rocking our family members purple and RIP in them and big up in them. But my wife's granddaddy, God rest his soul, this was his hat. And I'm showing him love and keeping his legacy rolling, wearing the hat. This was his hat. You know what I'm saying? But that's crazy you said granddaddy purple. You know what I mean? For me, my favorite was AK-47. Now, back in the day on the East Coast, my homies in D.C. would get that exotic AK-47 strain, and that shit hit harder than any weed anywhere else on the East Coast that I ever hit in my life. Couple hits of that, and you would be fucking high as hell gas. You wouldn't need a whole blunt of AK-47. You needed one or two hits, and you was done. That shit had to be like 40% or some shit. I don't even know. But that shit, when they said it was AK-47, what an AK-47 do? That's what that shit did. That shit was lethal. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I've had AK-47 before. It's a really nice, strong sativa. It's probably, to me, I believe, one of the strongest sativas that I've indulged in. Okay? I've had a few sativas. I'm not more of a sativa guy, okay, because I'm high strung. I can't sit down. I got to be busy. I either work with my hands or I got to do something. I'm creative, so I need something to induce and incite my creativity and enhance it and help me go to another plateau with it. So indicas do that for me. But I have had that AK-47, and yes, it does have a different euphoric. It has more of a, I'll say, of a mental euphoric feeling, high, so to speak, versus more of an indica that's going to give you more of a heavyweight body sort of euphoric high feeling that's going to want to make you sit on the couch or be more relaxed and relaxing. AK-47 is something that you could have a coffee with and hit in the morning and still function mentally. It's not going to want to have you all kind of like lazy, lackadaisical, or a nighttime strain. It's not a nighttime strain.
Yeah. You know, and then after everything was legalized out here in Cali, I came out here. My favorite strain out here that I ever smoked was Blue Diamond. And I got that shit out there in Long Beach many a times. The Blue Diamond had a lot of THC in it. So it got me really high. But then when I think about the strains and shit like that, it takes me to the gummies. And I got to ask you, would you prefer, if you could only do one more cannabis deed, would you rather it be a cannabis drink, a cannabis smoke, or a cannabis gummy? What would be your favorite to do if they say, $1 million, you can only have one more dose of cannabis, and this is your last dose before all time is up. Will you go gummy, will you go drink, or will you go smoke?
I'm a toker, I'm a smoker, you know what I'm saying? You know, midnight choker, you know what I'm saying? You dig, man? So I want to taste it like that, inhale it, enjoy the euphoric, see how it makes me react and choke, especially if it's the indica and it's tasty. I'm more of a smoke. I'm actually the Kush connoisseur, okay? So yeah. I'm a connoisseur of the smoke. I like the whole ritual of rolling up.
Rolling up. Now, do you prefer rolling papers, cones, or blunts? If you had only one thing to do for the rest of your life and somebody said, look, we're getting rid of cones, we're getting rid of all these other things, you have to pick one. Would it be blunt, the Dutch, you know what I mean, the cigar version, or the paper version? Which one would you go?
Okay, now check this out. Lately, okay, because I'm a blunt guy, okay? I've been smoking blunts. But there's a couple companies out here that have the 1¼-inch hemp papers, okay? And they're just as long as the blunt papers, okay? And I've been on a few of those lately, okay? Because I'm also old school. I like the orange zigzags, the white zigzags. And with the sticky icky, you would have to use at least 2 papers sometime to get it to really smoke well and attach, especially if it was a sticky, okay? So what I've been finding with a lot of these hemp companies, hemp papers, you know, such as Raw Vibes, Zigzag, and there's a couple other ones I can't remember, but I like to roll those up, and especially if I have like some good sticky, with 2 papers, okay? And they'll be just as long as a blunt, but they really smoke really nice like cigars, and you could actually put them out, okay? With certain type of cigar nicotine papers, like I remember the Phillies would just, no matter what type of marijuana you had in it, man, they just burn up. You would hit it, set it down, think you put it out in the ashtray, look up, be playing a video game or something, and look up, you have a long ash. Yep. I hate that. Oh my God. So these ones, they preserve. They actually can actually put out, because I smoked that, hit it once or twice, and you're going to have to either pass it and put it out, or, you know what I'm saying, ash it and pass it, man, or just like, yeah.
Yeah, you got to take a break when it's hitting hard like that. Me, I prefer the blunts, and the main reason why is because the way that the papers hit the back of my throat, you know what I'm saying? Like, they kind of scratch you up in the back of your throat when you're smoking the papers, but if you're smoking a blunt, it's always smooth, no matter if you got a Dutch or a Swisher Sweet or a White Owl or a Philly, a Backwood, a Double XL, any cigar paper you can find, you're going to have that smooth smoke where that shit go in and out.
Yep.
Like butter.
That's like, hey, man, that's, hey, man, shit, you make me want to. Right now, you know what I'm saying? you know, I'm a Doobie Brother, man, so you know what I'm saying? I'm one of the last of the true Doobie Brothers, too. Dig?
They from Philly.
Got the my
Doobie Brothers.
You know what I'm saying? I got my Doobie, man. You know, we still taking this shit to the streets around here, dig?
And you know, Valess actually made a song with Taking It to the Streets in it. And, you know, maybe I'll play that song when we ride out here. We only got a few minutes left. It looked like our other guest isn't going to be able to join us. So I guess before we get out of here, $1 million, Do you got any shout outs for the listeners? We got like 4 minutes left. I don't see him joining, but maybe you want to get before we get out of here.
Yeah, man, I'm keeping it in the air where it's fair for a player, man. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Sporty Six, Thrax, you know, Mac DZ, Date. All my loved ones, man, love is stronger. You know, my wife, my daughter, you know, my kids, you know, the whole West Coast. Shout out Kendrick, OG Suicide, you know what I'm saying? King Assassin, Green Guy, Vanessa, you know, all my folks, man. All my folks in the Bay, all my folks in L.A., Long Beach, you know what I'm saying? Compton, Inglewood, Watts, all that. Riverside.
Yeah, matter of fact, I'll be going out to Riverside tomorrow. My kids' cousins is out there, and, you know, they got to have their little cousin time and shit like that. So that should be real fun for them. Yeah, man, we'll play this little quick station identification.
Pomona, Pasadena, all of that.
Hey. You're listening to SOA Radio, hosted by DJ Green Guy. You know,
music with DJ. Commemorating the 50th anniversary of hip hop. Unmistakably so. It's DJ.
Everybody has a little hip hop.
I have to beat up a bird in
the 50th anniversary of hip hop. Represented.
Represented. Represent for hip hop.
DJ King Assassin.
50
is a hip hop.
Hip hop turns 50.
We will be here forever.
And we're celebrating.
Let me pop out.
That's the way he's in the house.
Forever. Music.
With DJ.
Hey, I just found out the other guest is going to join. We only got 2 minutes left on the Zoom, but he just, I don't know what happened over on his side of the world, but he just got free. So he may still be joining us if you want to get another forest fire 2 minute drill in here.
Come on with it, man. Okay. Shout out Section Strange, my family, oh boy, Cali, man. Cali Love, man. CT Terror, man. Y'all need to go out there and check out Ganja Boy on YouTube, man. You know what I'm saying? Go type in that www.sexandstrange.com, man. It's for adults only, man. You know, we letting you know the origins.